I'm Dr. Jennifer Verdolin, and this is Meet the Scientist, where I connect you with some remarkable researchers exploring questions that give us answers about ourselves and the world around us.
In this episode, we talk to vertebrate paleontologist Dr. Julie Meechan, who is uncovering new information about a previously undescribed species of wolf.
Well, I've always been interested in solving puzzles. I've always been interested in animals as well. And so when I was a kid, I used to love to go to museums and I used to love to look at the taxidermied animals. And when I did that, I found this love for mammals and for sort of reconstructing the past of mammals. Natural Trap Cave is a fossil site in northern Wyoming. It's at the base of the Bighorn Mountains. And it is about a 75-foot deep sinkhole where Pleistocene or Ice Age animals became entrapped. They would run over a hill and they wouldn't see the cave down below and they would fall 75 feet to their death. Natural Trap Cave is really special because there aren't very many sites like it. Because it's so deep and so protected, we really don't get the weathering that we get of the bones at other fossil sites. We find lots of really interesting animals down there. Some things that are still around in Wyoming today, such as pronghorn and bighorn sheep and bison. But we also have some really interesting stuff that went extinct at the end of the Ice Age, like mammoths and American lions. And the last species that I want to mention that we find at Natural Trap Cave are wolves. During the original excavations at Natural Trap Cave, they found a lot of wolves. These wolves were a point of contention because they didn't really know what kind of wolves they had. It was suggested that they were dire wolves, which is a species of wolf that went extinct at the end of the last ice age. Also, some scientists thought that they had modern gray wolves, the kind that we find today in Wyoming. When we looked at the collections that were in the Kansas Museum, which is where the old collections are kept today, there were some questions about the wolves that they had. They didn't really fit with either group. They looked too small to be dire wolves, and they looked too large to be gray wolves. So I didn't know what kind of wolves are at Natural Trap Cave. Some of the specific features we looked at to determine what kind of wolves we had at Natural Trap included the size of the skulls and the jaws. So our study mainly looked at the mandibles, or lower jaw, of the wolves. We also looked at the robustness of the teeth, the depth of the jaw, which gives us an idea of how much force they are using when they're chewing or cracking bones. And we also looked at how big the canine teeth were. What we found at Natural Trap Cave is actually a subspecies of wolf called the Beringian wolf. The Beringian wolf was famously noted from Alaska in the last ice age, and it was found to be both morphologically and genetically different from the living wolves of today and also from the dire wolves. This species seemed to come down through an opening in two glaciers from Alaska directly to Natural Trap Cave, Wyoming. Now that we know that the Beringian wolves actually were in Alaska and sort of in that part of the world, and that they came down first, this really muddles the waters of wolf evolution. Our next plan for this study of the Beringian wolves includes things like ancient DNA of the specimens that we found there. Other species have been successfully sequenced from Natural Trap Cave, including the American lion and the cheetah-like cat. The other thing we hope to do is look at the morphology of wolves along the path that they would have taken naturally after they came out of Natural Trap Cave. So along the glacier lines in Iowa, in South Dakota, in Indiana, possibly going the other way on the West Coast, so glacier lines in Oregon. And we'd also like to look at other Pleistocene gray wolf specimens in museum collections to see if we have possibly any more Beringian wolf anywhere else.